Now, movie critics are trying to dissuade audiences from watching a new film called Reagan, which sees Hollywood star Dennis Quaid depict the life of the actor turned 40th president of the United States, Ronald Reagan. The far-left publication Daily Beast called it the worst movie of the year and absolute trash. The LA Times called it historical hooey and childish slog of hero worship. But review website Rotten Tomatoes has... This really paints the picture, Kinsey. The critics' rating is 21%, but have a look at that audience rating, 98%. I think that says something. People are turning up in droves to see it. And I think audiences no longer really trust lefty media critics. They trust other viewers because they know the critics are normally got some sort of ideological reason for hating a particular film.
Yeah, I mean, it reminds me of the Christian movie, I Can Only Imagine. That movie grossed $86 million worldwide against a production budget of $7 million. Remember The Sound of Freedom? Critics canned it, and it became a box office hit, collecting $40 million after just 1 week. So I think you're absolutely right. The audience at home, they don't care what these elites think anymore. That those opinions are unnecessary and untrustworthy at this time.
And Kinsey, those Rotten Tomato rankings remind me of the Dave Chappelle and Hannah Gadsby phenomenon that was much talked about online, where you had the critic scores be polar opposite to the audience score. So with Hannah Gadsby, the critics loved it, the audience hated it. And with Dave Chappelle, it was the other way around. And I think it again shows there's this divide now where we don't trust the critical opinion. Things that are critically acclaimed may not be necessarily good.
And I think people are sick of, normal people are sick of watching movies with messages. And a lot of these critics are, you know, liberals. They're in the media world and they love these message-driven movies. Yeah. Normal people just want to get lost.
Well, you just want something that's well-written, well-acted, that's entertaining. I mean, I don't care if it's got a message, but if the whole point of the project is the message, then that's a problem. Now let's talk about the royals. Queen Camilla delighted American author Emily Griffin when she sent her a personal letter after they met at a literary event earlier this year. She told the author she enjoyed her work and was looking forward to reading her new book In the Peace and Quiet of Scotland. But I do wonder whether Meghan is going to see this as a slight, given Griffin has publicly called Meghan unmaternal and phony in a series of comments that she did later apologise for, but as we know, Meghan and Harry do not forget anything.
That's right. Knowing how sensitive Harry and Meghan are, I absolutely believe that this would drive Meghan Markle crazy. You know, Emily's comments didn't cross any lines and they weren't necessarily cruel, but unfortunately for Emily, she made these comments in that 24-month period after the Oprah Winfrey interview where you were not allowed to critique Meghan Markle or you were canceled. Then, you know, remember Bethany Frankel saying, after I posted a negative video about Meghan Markle, a superstar called me and scolded me. Then South Park kind of changed everything. But that's really why Emily had to apologize and received such backlash. I doubt Meghan is happy about this new friendship blossoming between Camilla and Emily.
Kinsey Schofield, thank you so much for your time this evening.